Welcome to the next session of correlation. We are in the process of doing some numerical problems based on the concept of Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation. Let us see the problems. For the bivariate data, R of x comma y is equal to question mark. Look at this, sir. First observation, 15 20 25 30 are the values of x. X values are increasing. This is 3 8 13 18. Y values are also increasing. It means both the variables are moving in the same direction. Both the variables are moving in the same direction. It means correlation is positive. Nature is identified. Let us see the extent of relationship. Okay, now difference of two variables in each bracket is a constant. Difference of two variables in each bracket is a constant. So x minus y is equal to 12. X minus y minus 12 equal to 0. X coefficient is positive. Y coefficient is negative. Now x coefficient and y coefficient have opposite sign. X coefficient and y coefficient have opposite sign, therefore r is equal to plus 1. Okay. Next question. Question number two. X is 13579. Sorry. X is 5 6 7 8 9 10 11. Y is equal to 15 17 19 21 23 25 27. R of x comma y is equal to question mark. Now look at this observation, sir. For a unit change in the value of x, means x values are changing by 1. So here delta x is equal to 1, delta y is equal to 2. For a unit change in the value of x, the corresponding change in the other variable is constant. Over the entire range of values, then correlation is said to be linear. when correlation is linear means the graph is always a straight line. When correlation is linear means the graph is always a straight line. So y is equal to mx plus c, or you can write y is equal to ax plus b. Now if I calculate the value of a, then I can predict what will be the answer for this question. Okay, a is equal to slope of the line. Slope of the line, this is delta y by delta x, 2 by 1 2. So y is equal to 2x plus b. I'm not interested about the value of constant b. You can write this as 2x minus y plus b equal to 0. You can also write this as 2x minus y plus b equal to 0. X coefficient is positive. Y coefficient is negative. X coefficient is positive, y coefficient is negative. When x coefficient and y coefficient have opposite sign, r is equal to minus, sorry, r is equal to plus 1. R is equal to plus 1. Again, I am repeating this point. When x coefficient and y coefficient have opposite sign, then r is equal to plus 1. Okay, let us see the next question. Now this time my data is given in this manner. X values are increasing, y values are decreasing. Nature of the relationship is negative. Nature of the relation is negative. But extent of the relation I have to calculate. Now look at this. Delta x is equal to 1. Delta y is equal to minus 2. For a unit change in the value of one variable, for a unit change in the value of one variable, the corresponding change in the other variable is a constant. So correlation is linear. In case of linear correlation, the graph is a straight line. In case of a linear correlation, the graph is a straight line. So again, I can write y is equal to ax plus b. Y is equal to ax plus b, where a is equal to slope of the line. A is equal to slope of the line. A is equal to delta y divided by delta x. So minus 2 by 1 is minus 2. So y is equal to minus 2x plus b. Bring all the values to the left hand side. Bring all the values to the left hand side. It is 2x plus y minus b is equal to 0. Now x coefficient is positive, y coefficient is positive, x coefficient is positive, y coefficient is positive. When these two variables are having same sign, means x coefficient and y coefficient have same sign, r is minus 1. So r is equal to minus 1. R is equal to minus 1. So there is a perfect negative correlation between the two variables. There is a perfect negative correlation between the two variables. Okay. Let us see question number 4. Thank you. Now, x is equal to minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Small y is equal to 3, minus 3, minus 4, 0, 4, 1, 2, minus 2, minus 1. R of x comma y is equal to question 1. R of x comma y is equal to question 1. Now sir, R is equal to summation of small xy by summation of x square under root into summation of y square under root. Let us see summation of xy. Minus 4 into 3 minus 12 plus 9 plus 8, 0, again 0, this is 1, this is 4, minus 6, minus 1. So this is minus 12, minus 6, minus 18, minus 22, plus 4, minus 4, cancel. So minus 12, minus 6 is minus 18. Plus 9 plus 8 is 17 plus 1 18. This is 0. Summation of xy is 0. So 0 divided by whatever may be the denominator value except 0. It cannot be 0 here. Squaring means negative values will become positive. Denominator is not equal to 0. 0 divided by denominator 0. R is equal to 0. R is equal to 0. Okay, let's see one more question. Question number 5. Minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 27, 18, 11, 6, 3, 2, 3, 6, 11, 18, 27. R of x comma y is equal to question mark. R of x comma y is equal to question mark. Okay. Now look at this, sir. This is 0 anyway. 0 into 2 is 0. XY value. Summation of xy in fact. Now, right hand side it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Left hand side it is minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. And the y values are also same. 3, 6, 11, 18, 27. 3, 6, 11, 18, 27. So, product of these two, if I add the right hand side values, product xy and the left hand side, these values get cancelled with each other. Plus 3 minus 3, plus 12 minus 12, plus 33 minus 33 this way. So summation of xy is 0 here. Summation of xy is 0. So R is equal to summation of xy by summation of x square under root into summation of y square under root. 0 by denominator, this is 0. Let's see the next question. Question number 6. R is equal to 0.8 summation of xy. This is equal to 60. Standard deviation of y is equal to 2.5. And summation of x square is equal to 90, where small x and small y are the deviations. Are the deviations from the respective means? From the respective means, find the number of terms. Find the number of items. Okay, we have option A 8, option B 9, option C 10, option D 11. Okay. Now, let us see this. R is equal to summation of xy by x minus x bar into y minus y bar by n. Covariance of x comma y is written. 1 by standard deviation of y, I will keep it as it is, into 1 divided by standard deviation of x, I am writing this way. So this is square root of n will go to the numerator. Into 1 by standard deviation of y, r is equal to, this is square root of n, will go here root times, summation of xy by root n, into 1 by summation of x square, into 1 by standard deviation of y, these are. So square root of m is equal to summation of xy by r into 1 by summation of x square into 1 by standard deviation of y. This is one way of solving the question. So this is summation of xy 60. R is equal to 0.8, 1 by 90 under root into 1 divided by 2.5. Now let us see this. Ninety under root multiplied with 2.5 multiplied with 0.8 is equal to resulting value stored in the memory, 60 divided by MRC, this is 3.16227 under root is equal to, so n is equal to, into is equal to, this is 10. This is one way of solving the question. This is one way of solving the question. Okay, have a look on the solution. Okay, another alternative approach is without bringing any changes, R is equal to summation of xy by n into 1 by standard deviation of y, 1 by x square by n under root, keep it as it is. Take n value from the options, first put n is equal to 8 here, for n is equal to 8, if LHS equal to RHS, then 8 is the answer to the given question. If LHS is not equal to RHS for n is equal to 8, then go for n is equal to 9, go for n is equal to 10, this way you can verify. It depends on your convenience which method you want to follow. These are the two alternatives you have. Take n value from options. Take n value from options and verify for what value of n left hand side is equal to right hand side. That is the answer to the given question. Anyway, you can solve. Okay, next question. Question number 7. If the covariance between two variables is 20, variance of one variable is 16, what would be the variance of the other variable? What would be the variance of other variable? Option A, more than 100. Option B, more than 10. Option C, less than 10. More than 1.25. This way we have. Now once again, look at the data given to us. Covariance of x comma y is 20. Let us take variance of one variable is 16. So standard deviation is 4. You have to calculate the variance of other variable. Covariance is a numerical number. Covariance is a positive value, numerical number in the sense it is a positive value. Now let us see, keep this point in your mind. What is the original inequality we have for R? Minus 1 is less than or equal to R. R is less than or equal to 1. But covariance is a positive value. So 0 less than R, R is less than or equal to 1. So R value greater than 0 but less than or equal to 1. This inequality I am using here. R is less than or equal to 1. So covariance of x comma y divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y is less than or equal to 1. 20 divided by 4 into 1 by standard deviation of y less than or equal to 1. 5 is less than or equal to standard deviation of 5. Variance of y is greater than or equal to 25. Now, let us see here, these are all inequalities, more than 100, more than 10, more than 1.25. Let us represent the value on a real line. This is variance of y is 1.25, greater than means right hand side. Second one is more than 10. It is variance of y is equal to 10. On the first line also, variance of 10 you have here. Variance of y as 10. So for these two lines, it is the common value. Let us see one more inequality, more than 100. Variance of y is equal to 100. So here variance of y is equal to 100. Here variance of y is equal to 100. Common area starts from this. Common area starts from this. Common area, which is solution to the given problem. Which is solution area to the given problem. So common area will start from variance is 100. So option A, more than 100 is the answer to the given problem. More than 100 is the answer to the given question. Given r of x comma y is equal to 0.48, covariance of x comma y, covariance of x comma y is 36, variance of x is 16, standard deviation of y is equal to question mark. Standard deviation of y is equal to question mark. Now, variance of x is given 16. So, standard deviation of x is 4. By taking the square root here, standard deviation of x is 4. R is equal to covariance of x comma y divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. So standard deviation of y is equal to covariance of x comma y by standard deviation of x into R. Covariance is 36, 0.48 into 4. So this is 0.48 into 4 is equal to memory plus 36 divided by MRC is equal to 18.75. This is 18.75. Let's see the next question. Question number 9. This is X series, Y series, number of observations, number of observations 15 and 15, arithmetic mean 25 and 18, standard deviation 5, 5, summation of x minus 25 into y minus 18 is equal to 125. R of x comma y is question. Now look at the data given to us. Standard deviation of x is given as 5. Standard deviation of y is also given as 5. What is required for me? Covariance is required. Covariance of x comma y is equal to summation of x minus x bar into y minus y bar by n. It is given x bar is 25, y bar is 18. So summation of x minus 25 into y minus 18 by n. So this is 125 divided by 15. This is equal to 8.33. So R is equal to covariance of x comma y divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. 8.33 divided by 5 and 5. 8.33 divided by 25. 8.33 divided by 25. This is 0.3333. This is recurring. Okay, sir. Next, look at the next question. Question number 10. Variance of x is equal to variance of y is equal to 1/4. And variance of x minus y is equal to 1/3. Then R of x comma y is question mark. Now here it is variance as a linear combination. So variance of x comma y is equal to variance of x plus variance of y minus 2 times covariance of x comma y. This is the formula. Variance of x comma y is equal to variance of x plus variance of y minus 2 times covariance of x comma y. Variance of x comma y is given as 1/3. Variance of x is 1/4. Variance of y is 1/4 minus 2 times covariance of x comma y. Look at this. R is equal to covariance of x comma y divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. So covariance of x comma y r into standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y, r into standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y, 1 by 2 minus 2 times r into 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, variance of x is 1 by 4, when you take square root for this you will get standard deviation which is 1 by 2. Again, variance of y also 1 by 4, when you take square root for this it is 1 by 2. So 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2 is equal to minus 1 by 2 into r. If I take 6 as LCM, minus 1 by 6 is equal to minus r by 2. R is equal to 2 by 6, 1 by 3. R value is equal to 1 by 3. Next question. If y is equal to a plus bx, then what is the coefficient of correlation? Then what is the coefficient of correlation between x and y? Option A1, option B, minus 1, option C, 1 or minus 1, according as B is greater than 0 or B less than 0. Option D, none of this. Option D. Now look at this solution, very simple question. Y is equal to A plus BX. Take Y to other side, BX minus Y plus A equal to 0. Or you can say, you can keep it as it is, y is equal to a plus bx, which is a line, okay, which is a line equation. When it is a line equation means correlation is linear, which is a line equation means correlation is linear. Okay, sir. When it is a linear correlation, graph is a straight line. That we know very well. Now you have to identify what type of correlation it is having. One more point to observe is, in case of linear correlation, it is a perfect positive correlation or a perfect negative correlation. It is a perfect positive correlation or a perfect negative correlation. That is, r is equal to 1 or minus 1. either it is perfect to positive correlation or perfect to negative correlation. How can I say this? That entirely depends on slope of the line. When B is positive, that is slope is positive, it is a rising line. It is a rising line. Then R is equal to 1. When B is negative, that is slope is negative, it is falling line. Then R is equal to minus 1. So the decision is dependent on slope, B value. So option C is the answer to the given question. It may be a positive one or it may be a negative one according as B greater than 0 or B less than 0. Okay. So that's all in this, remaining in the next session. Thank you.